have a logo photo of James Gunn's Superman.
All right. There it is. So this is the updated cover for Superman.
Kingdom Come, right? Like Kingdom Come Superman? Is that what we're doing?
Yeah, that's where we're going.
Kind of what it looks like, yes. And am I gonna do it?
Let's not do it. We're having a good night. Let's not do it. All right. But if you guys want to go to Twitter and look at the fucking picture, that there's a set photo of Superman in full underoos.
The cape is up to the bottom of his the halfway of his knees.
I feel like if we're gonna talk about it, we kind of have
to. All right, just fucking show it. We'll see if we get whatever.
I mean, like, it is what it is, bro. Like, I don't
know. Just fucking show the picture.
All right, listen.
That's what the chat is for, bro. Just fucking show this shit, bro. Listen, first of all, the cape looks like it's made for him to curtsy and shit, bro. Like, this shit is terrible.
So I don't know who made wish.com Superman, but I need that person to go figure out their life.
That's Alibaba, bro. I don't even think that's Wish, bro.
It's
that's
so bad. It's so
I'm not even
mad at the colors. I'm mad at the cape. I'm mad at the cape more than anything, I think.
Yeah, it just
I'm mad at everything.
Dude, they have to differentiate themselves from Zack Snyder, right? So they're not going to do the dark, ominous tone color. They're not. Right. They included the fucking underwear and the belt. They included the, you know what I mean? They made it bright and vibrant. Like they Zack. Listen, it is what it is. Zack Snyder, James Gunn went every way he could to differentiate himself from Zack Snyder.
Yeah, it's just too different, bro.
It's very obvious. Different.
And then the cape is like cropped on a circular. Like, what Superman has is, first of all, this is Shazam's cape in all red. This is Shazam's cape in all red, bro.
It's kind of what it looks like. It's really like I said, I can deal with the suit. It's the cape, man. And I hope in post they freaking CGI the crap out of it and don't make, like, I think they're going to see the reaction to this and be like, oh, we need to fix the cape. Like, I really think they fix the cape.
I don't like the way it looks. Let me just start there. I don't want to be overly critical, but part of me is just like, you guys are probably going to be like, what the fuck? But like, part of me just will always think that Superman is kind of just a corny looking character in general because he's looked the same since the dawn of time. Like he's the first fucking superhero. He's the guy in the red tights,
man. First OP
and the spandex and the fucking S on the. He's the first guy, right? So he's always gonna look a tinge of corny. So it is what it is. But the guy on the left literally looks like the corniest dude I've ever seen at a costume party in my life. Like it's like I would look at him and be like, okay, like, bro, you went a little...
But wait, how do you get the logo wrong?
Well, that's James Gunn's logo. That's
No, I'm telling you, they're going to do some weird Kingdom Come situation. They have to be.
Look at the S on the one on the right, and look at the S on the one on the left.
I know.
It doesn't. It looks like a swoosh. It looks like a red line going, okay, no Superman, no.
I know.
By the way, just for reference, in case anybody wonders what the photo on the right is, that's the reference photo from when we saw James Gunn reading that book. That's from All-Star Superman.
Yes.
So that's from the run of All-Star Superman. So that's what that Superman looked like in that run of comics. And this is his translation of that.
I mean, here's something weird, too.
Do it that way you will.
Here's something weird, too. We've never actually seen, and correct me if I'm wrong, in a live action, we've never seen a Superman costume change really like drastic. Like maybe this is suit one and he changes it. Maybe this is like the Krypton suit and like he makes I don't know.
I'm sorry. The Christopher Reeve suit looked 10 times better than this.
Of course it did.
All right.
It does. But it does. Like, listen, he's trying to modernize it and he has, dude, it's like, listen, you can't go with the dark ominous colors. You can't. After Zack Snyder, you just can't. You have to brighten it up.
I know, but I'm not even talking about Zack Snyder. I'm talking about Christopher Reeves. His suit looks better than this shit that I'm looking at right now.
I mean, I'm not mad at
the back in the 80s.
Listen, I think his logo looks good, but if you go suit to suit, aside from the cape is ass. We could all agree the cape is ass. But like the colors of the suit, like those are the colors of the suit, man.
I think
the logo is trash. That's what I think is trash.
The logo and the cape is killing me.
I'm not mad at the colors. I'm mad at the overall style because what they tried to do was merge some of the old stuff and then modernize some of the new stuff, and it doesn't go. Yo, the little underoo, he got on the Aquaman underoo underwear shit, bro. Like
they knew they were gonna do it. You knew they were gonna do it
with the little decoder belt buckle. What the fuck is that?
You knew they were gonna do it. You knew that's you had to have known they were gonna do it, bro.
I got underwear with a belt loops in it.
I hope this picture is fake. Like I hope someone put this on the internet and like let me get on. I hope
this is some AI shit, bro. Seriously, because this shit is terrible.
I hope they're messing with us. I hope someone got us tonight. I hope they did.
And the S on his chest looks like it's off center. Just saying.
It's not even an S. It's literally just like a line.
It literally is like a line going from left to right.
That's why I'm really wondering: is this even fucking real?
Well, it looks more like a Mortal Kombat logo.
Okay, right? So. Let's also remember that even though we're used to seeing an S on his chest, that the S doesn't actually stand for Superman. So
I think it stands for hope.
We'll go with the more symbol based thing on his chest to represent his family.
Right.
It still looks like shit, James.
It looks awful.
It looks like shit.
So for what it's worth, I was we have some comments here. Obviously, we can kind of catch up on here. So. Polar initially said, bro.
Yeah, we know, bro.
I don't know what to think. And then I think this is Johnny Fish.
Yep, this is like literally all of our sentiments.
I don't like the cape and the S. Yeah. Henry Cavill switching to the black suit was so great. Agreed. I love the black suit, Superman. Just I was gonna say that. You know, I don't know. The Superman Returns costume was missing a yellow S on the back of the cape. Hated that. Okay.
Yep.
I think that's a valid point.
That's valid. Does he have the S on the back?
Yeah, we don't know. Judging from this, I'm gonna assume he does, but I don't know. I think that photo on the left is AI. Please, it's supposedly a leaked photo. We don't know.
Yeah, alleged. Least, it's all alleged.
At least they got the spit curl right.
Wait, did they?
I mean, it's a spit curl.
It looks accurate.
It's not down the middle, bro. It's not down the middle.
Yeah, listen, it's accurate.
It looks like he works at a gas station out in Kansas, but, you know, I guess that's...
My man looks like Paco.
Yo, I hope it's me.
In gun, I trust. This is a fake pic.
I hope so, man.
I don't know.
I hope so,
Nostalgic, you trust in James... Oh, Lord.
Speaking of which, do you want to just like jump right to the next thing?
Yeah, that's the end. Let's bring the beef.
Okay. All right.
Let's kill it right now.
So we're going to end the podcast talking about July 2025. So, I mean, I guess I'll just, since I intro'd it, I guess I'll just. So Superman Legacy and the Fantastic Four both come out in the same month in 2025, which I kind of think is Marvel sticking it to James Gunn a little bit by putting it out in the same exact month, if that's the case. So I guess let's lead with the question. What do we think will be the better project and what will make more money in the box office in July of 2025?
Fantastic Four, and it's not even close.
Really? Really? Yeah. Really?
The man changed the name of the movie to Superman. What happened to the legacy part?
Yeah, bro, but it's Superman. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think
and people that's will the go Fantastic see. Four, bro.
Wait. Before Leo continue, before you continue, Abel. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. But keep in mind, we've had really shitty Fantastic Four movies. Just saying, I don't know how many people are hyped to go to the theater and go see Fantastic Four again. Because if it bombs, like, it's going to be bad, bro. I hate to tell you. It's going to be bad if it bombs.
Right. Let me give it to you the other way. For the last how many years I've seen a halfway decent Superman. You know what I haven't seen halfway decent? I haven't seen a halfway decent Fantastic Four.
That's all I'm saying.
And if I think the first 2 weeks, the first 2 weeks will be a very telling thing for these two movies. If I get an incredible Fantastic Four, I will go see that movie two or three times in the theaters. And I might see Superman, maybe. But at the end of the day, I've had a decent Superman. I have not had a good Fantastic Four.
That's my point.
Okay.
That's
my point. I don't know. This is my point. Fantastic Four, Marvel's first family, never done in the MCU. Take all the bullshit besides Silver Surfer, take all the bullshit out of Fantastic Four from there. So this is MCU. This is literally James Gunn versus Kevin Feige. And I think that Kevin Feige is going to put his motherfucking foot in this goddamn movie. Because this is what his next 10 years, you want to be the Disney, the Marvel director for Disney? Show me what you got in this movie.
You want to talk about where Kevin Feige's attention is right now? It's only in one place. Only in one place.
About Deadpool and Wolverine. He doesn't have to worry about that.
I think he knows he can't miss on Fantastic Four.
Exactly. That's why.
Miss on Fantastic
Four. No, he can't. It's the one movie he can't miss on.
I think this kind of comes down to, as we all said, a couple of facts. For me, this comes down to, does Superman, which was Superman Legacy, which is now Superman, is this now just another origin story movie? The Fantastic Four, again, we've seen this thing crash several times. So what's going to be new in the presentation that we haven't seen from the other movies and whatnot? So this is going to come down to the delivery system and what the overall story is. We still don't really know what Superman Legacy is supposed to be, and now that it's just Superman, it just makes me feel like they copped out at the last minute and decided to go traditional, and we're going to get the origin story and all of that, and which is, you know, people have seen this shit already. Superman, unfortunately, is just one of those favorites that audience have always loved. People will go see it time and time again, but they didn't have other options at the same time. Marvel has shown, even in their failures, to destroy DC movies at the theater. They destroy them.
Because why? The following's too big, DC man. Fans don't what?
Support. They don't show up to the theater.
Support.
They don't show up to the theater.
We're gonna touch on some comments here because there's a lot going on in the comment section right now.
I have some thoughts on these comments actually.
But yeah. So the only thing I will also say is that what I was gonna say is, you want to talk about two trailers that are gonna determine a lot of shit.
Yeah.
When these two trailers come out, which is gonna be around the same fucking time, oh buddy, oh boy, is it gonna be fucking big?
Yeah.
Bro, I mean, I need to see some shit from both of these trailers in order to get me to go see the movies in theaters. I gotta see some shit. Like some real shit. Because I was on, you all know, I was rocking with James Gunn up until a couple weeks ago. I was like, I think it's actually going to be a good movie. And now the more the changes come out, I'm kind of like, I kind of want to retract my statement, but I'm going to stick with it. I think it'll smooth out okay, honestly. But all right, let's get to some comments here real quick. So Fantastic Four, without a doubt. Yep. Fantastic Four, hands down. It's a 1v4.
It's a 1v4. Damn, that's good.
The anticipation for Disney's Fantastic Four is massive, but a lot of people were let down by the casting or didn't like it as much. All right, whatever. Superman will be the bigger fan film.
It's very interesting.
I really do think it will. I think it might be, bro. I think he's not wrong on that take.
Dude,
I actually know. I think he's like, what up?
Marvel. Would you want to see Marvel fans geek out? Do you want to see Marvel fans geek out? Wolverine, Deadpool will let you know. Because you're going to have DC fans coming to see Wolverine and Deadpool.
But here's the...
Our movies, even if they're fucking bad.
here's the problem, and it's this comment right here. Superman is very well casted.
I'm in agreement. I really am. Outside of the fact that I... Listen, outside of the fact that I really would have liked to see Henry Cavill back, I think them getting Henry Cavill Jr., he looks exactly the fucking same.
Right.
Like, so I don't really
and
care.
And dude, Holt playing Lex Luthor, like, yeah,
like their casting the other, is really good.
The Leo. Other, it's the really other Justice good. League people that they're sprinkling in this movie, like there is some very good casting here, and I'll agree. But here's where I do not think the Fantastic Four is bad casting. I really don't. Marvel hasn't like you can say what you want about like their writing and all that stuff. Their casting is mint. Like it is. Their casting is mint. And you can say whatever you want about Pedro Pascal being a Hispanic Reed Richard. I don't care. I don't want to hear it. Like look at Joel and look at The Last of Us. That's all I have to even say at this point. Yeah. That's it. He is an actor who has incredible acting chops, and he will hopefully take this role and fucking kill it. That's it.
I like Pedro Pascal as a
person. I don't agree with the Pedro Pascal hate. I really don't.
No, I don't hate him.
No. It's well, every, like, fans, it's out there hate, though. It's very out there.
Yeah, it is. People, a lot of people are hating.
Dude, listen. I like Quinn as Human Torch. I like Sue Reed, and I like the guy they picked as his thing. The guy from what, The Bear? Are you kidding me? Like, yo, dude.
Listen, I'm going to hold you. Like, Boss. At this point, the me liking this movie is critical of their presentation of the thing. Because he is
100%.
I will.
If they fuck up the thing, I'm definitely going to be pissed on this movie.
Chase, when I tell you, Eben Moss Baccarat, he's gonna be good in that role.
He's gonna be
I
incredible. Swear to you.
He's a solid.
You're gonna get the Brooklyn out of that.
Yeah, you are. You're gonna get. He's gonna be able to.
Not so much actor, but because at this point,
how he looks.
Are we suiting him up? Are we CGIing him? The presentation of the thing.
Did you see when the actor went on? He was on a night show recently. Did you see what he said at all?
No,
Eben. He said that Marvel already told him that it's not good. It's going to be CGI. There's no suit.
It's going to be like a Hulk situation.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's just where things are now. Because people said that suit back in the day when they did the Fantastic Four. People, whoever was the actor in that suit, hated it. Like absolutely hated being in that suit. That shit was like shit. I mean, my thing is though that like when you guys don't understand like. I need to see a Fantastic Four trailer, and I need to see if Pedro Pascal can convince me he's Reed Richards. I'm fucking invested.
Right.
But I need to see it the same way I saw him convince me he's Joel. He needs to convince me he's fucking.
I mean, Reed dude, Richards. it's really like even just looking at the comments, dude. It comes down to Reed. It really does. Right,
let's get to the comments. Let's get some more comments.
All right. We'll just.
Throw it in there. It's whatever.
Legacy is not at Origins. Gunn said he's already Superman for 3 years. Okay.
Right. You. Fine. What was the last time I saw Batman on year two? How'd that work out? Okay.
No. But I think James Gunn did already kind of say he wasn't going to be a new suit. Like a new
yeah, Superman, yeah. Like a, that's fine. No, listen, just give it to me.
They will make it about race and divide people with 1960s Hispanic guy dating a white woman.
I don't think they will.
Pedro Pascal passes for white.
Pedro Pascal kind of does best for white.
Dude, Last of Us Joel, man. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
That's it. Who is Pedro Pascal cast? Then do you see that image? Not saying he's a bad actor. Okay.
No, that's
just
fine.
Saying he's a, no, no, I would agree.
It's
would
not like it's not right for Reed. I get that part of it, but like
I would have not liked
I trust
either.
I trust Marvel, and I trust Pedro Pascal's acting to kill it.
Okay, if he's not the right, if you don't trust him as Reed, who would you put in there?
I would have loved Krasinski. I would have loved Krasinski back.
We got fucking two lines from Krasinski in that movie.
That's fine, but I would have loved Krasinski back because I know John Krasinski can be that role.
But the one thing is that I'm telling you guys now that this is back in the '60s. First Fantastic Four. This is not going to be heavily. What I'm going to say is not going to be like heavily. It's more clobbering time type of thing. You're going to get. You're going to get the nostalgia of the old Fantastic Four, the original stuff. So that's why I think he's bringing it out on the same month as Superman Legacy. So you want to go old school? I'm gonna go old school as well. I'm gonna bring out my first family and let's see who rocks first.
not by Reed, not by
Reed. Dude, it's so insane. Dude, that's what it is, man. A lot of people are just not about Reed.
Everyone was perfect, but Pedro, let's just keep it real.
Listen, it's listen, yet to be seen. I
do not count Pedro out, bro. Like, he is, if anybody that can bring this shit to fruition, it's definitely him. Don't get me wrong. He just wasn't everybody's first choice. We didn't see that coming.
Yeah, no, no one saw that coming. Actor, bro. No one saw that coming. And this one, this one too. This
Keep it Thorough Comics, welcome on in. Pedro Pascal was better off getting casted as Maxwell Lord by gun than to be Reed Richards. Nostalgic, I'm with you. Pedro is not good pick for Reed, even though he's a great actor. But I can understand that sentiment. Like, I really can't. I love Pedro Pascal. I just, dude, I don't know how I'm going to feel about him in this role. I said beginning.
I'll say it like this, and like, I'm not going to compare these two, so like, don't take it this way. But like, I remember when Heath Ledger was casted for Joker, and like, that was a joke. I'm not saying it's going to be on that level.
I get it.
All I'm saying is you just don't know what they see that we don't. That's all I'm saying. They might see something that we do not, and I'm hoping that's the case. But like, you know. Listen, I get it. I just don't know.
It's all about being true. He's nostalgic, saying it's not about his ethnicity. It's about being true to characterization. I can understand, bro. Nostalgic, I can understand what you're saying. I really, really do. I get what you're saying. I just do think that he's a good enough actor to play the role. I just need to see it. That's where I'm at right now. I need to see it. I used to trust Marvel up until Love and Thunder.
All right. So my point on Love and Thunder. Marvel inherently has a villain problem. Their problem is villains, right? A lot of that problem was villains. Like, if you look at a lot of their heroes and the majority of them, they're well casted. Like, listen, I will be the first to tell you I hated She-Hulk, but that woman in the role was well casted and she played it right. Woman who played She-Hulk.
Who played She-Hulk? That's what you're talking about.
She's fantastic. Like, even like Oscar Isaac's as Moon Knight. Like, we can go on and on. Like, I feel like a lot of the heroes, Brie Larson, right? Right, Aaron? Like, Brie Larson, that's great. But, but I understand. I understand where you're all coming from. I do.
Also, isn't the Fantastic Four set in the 60s?
It is.
Yep.
Well,
where is Superman set at, though?
The original was set in the 60s, so this is where the beginning of this happened. We just don't know how long they're going to stay in the 60s. Has not been set out in the story.
They mentioned time jumps and shit. I don't know. And if my thing is, like, to your point, Leo, because they're saying they want X-Men and Mutants and Fantastic Four to be Phase 7. Are you really going to get Pedro Pascal for multiple phases of Marvel? Is that really a thing? Are you really going to get him that long? That's the thing.
The storyline that... I don't want to do this again.
Polar, you're a fucking maniac.
Polar. Holy shit.
He donated $5 to say not my Reed again to read it. Thank you, Polar.
Polar, thank you. Polar, you're a legend.
Thank you, man. Thank you. I appreciate it.
So nice.
Don't get me wrong. I want Fantastic Four to be dope, but Legacy is going to be the superior film. Isn't it weird that I strangely do think that Legacy might be a better movie? I just have a weird
you might not listen, James. I agree with you, Fatal J. James Gunn has a point to prove right now. He has a point to prove.
Yep.
It's gonna be a battle, and I can't wait to see the trailers.
I feel like flip a coin at the like it could literally go either way because I don't know.
Fatal J, by the way, a good point. Pedro's up in age too. I wasn't even saying it from an age perspective, but yes, agreed with you. My thing is Pedro Pascal's so fucking busy. That's the thing. Pedro Pascal has to do The Last of Us Season 2. He's going to be in a bunch of other fucking projects. So is Marvel going to get him over the long haul? Fuck no, they're not. No way. They're going to have to recast him at some point and make it a younger Reed Richards. I'm telling you, they're going to have to do that.
Yeah.
There's just no way. It's going to be a time jump. I've been doing the deep dive on the storyline that I think they're going to go with.
They're gonna go with, okay.
So I'm not gonna do that. They're going to go with a certain storyline. If I'm right, before the movie comes out, I would give my predictions a month before.
All right. Well, listen,
I want to do more research.
If the rumors that you're going to get Silver Surfer and Galactus are correct, there's definitely a time jump because he does not show up in the 60s in their original, you know what I'm saying, in their original origin story. That's the Fantastic Four and Dr. Doom story in the beginning. So by the time you get to Galactus and the Silver Surfer, it's no longer that period of time. At this point, he already has the Baxter Building, which he will not have in the 60s. So there's got to be time jumps.
At 100%.
It's going to have to be. They chose the 60s because I guarantee the Deadpool 3 post-credits will be Deadpool killing the Fox Fantastic Four and introducing the new Fantastic Four.
I wouldn't be surprised. Wow. I wouldn't be surprised if they kill him. I don't know if they'll introduce him, though.
I haven't heard that, but that's okay. Fantastic Four is almost cursed. Think about the three adaptations.
Mm-hmm. That's Fox, bro. That's Fox. Take it away. Take it away.
The guy from Den of Nerds had an incredible theory that I loved. So it's going to take place in two timelines, and Galactus will be a thing, but he'll have two different Harolds based off the time. Oh. So like he'll jump in the 60s and maybe have like a Silver Surfer as his like first Harold or whatever, but then maybe they'll jump into the future and like this is where Terrax comes in. Maybe Terrax is the new Harold, but like Silver Surfer comes in to whatever, save the
Silver
day.
Silver Surfer wasn't the first Harold. I know, but I just
thought the whatever it is, the different Harolds and time jump, but you're both dealing with Galactus. I thought was a very interesting concept, and it's something we've never seen. I actually really like.
I think I like that theory a lot. If they jump to Galactus at the first movie, this movie is gonna suck. I can tell you that right now.
But that's what they're talking about, bro. We haven't heard anybody outside of Galactus yet.
Exactly. That's the way Marvel wants to keep it.
Also, by the way,
let them keep it that way.
And I'm just going to put these up. Fatal J and Nostalgic, that's been debunked. There's no Silver Surfer female.
There
is a Silver Surfer female.
Not in the movie.
There is in the
comic. They're not doing that for the movie.
We said that, like,
we kind of figured that out, but.
Yeah, and I also think this might Wolverine and Deadpool come out when
July of this year, so we'll have a lot more answers.
I think that's also going to be one of the precursors whether people really support the Fantastic Four movie if Wolverine and Deadpool turns out to be the blockbuster that we all think that it's going to be. I don't know. At that point, like, people might, if they do this thing right, people are going to be hungry for that Fantastic Four movie in a vicious way.
Yep. I can don't mess with Norn Rad. Thanks. I hope Doom will be in this and Doom will end up being the big bad. I think Doom gets
Give me a little something. I don't need the whole
post-credit
thing.
Post-credit scene.
If there's anyone that I want to build in this world, it's freaking Doom.
Yeah, post-credit scene for sure. Oh, man.
You got to realize Doom crosses over to X-Men. Doom crosses over to Black Panther. Doom crosses over to so much.
Doom crosses over to everything, bro.
Everything, right.
Because he is another true big bad.
Right.
And we have a lot of big bads that we can go down the line with. Mm-hmm. Fantastic Four, X-Men, Avengers, and everybody. There's a lot of big bads that we have to go. The thing is like everybody's been saying, is the story going to be told right?
Yep.
And that's what it's all down to. It's not down to who's playing the part. It's not down to what timeline they're in. It's down to how it was written and how it shows up on film.
Yeah, the execution.
The execution is what counts. Because if I get a shitty ass Superman.
Right. Well, it's the same thing with Fantastic Four. I better not get a shitty ass Fantastic Four. Like,
exactly.
Like I said, flip a coin.
It has to land. It has to land right. Both movies has to land right. James Gunn has a lot on the line. Kevin Feige has a lot on the line. Mm-hmm. Both of them have a lot on the line. And a lot of futures are planned in this.
Can you all imagine a scenario. I'm just saying I don't want to, like, because we talked about it a lot last week. Could you imagine a scenario where the Fantastic Four is a great fucking movie, and then at the end you get a post-credit scene and Dr. Doom pulls his fucking mask off and it's Henry Cavill? Can you imagine the shot? Can you imagine the shot to James Gunn, bro? The fucking punch in the face to James Gunn if that happens.
No, Abel had a good take last week. Abel had a good take last week.
Which one?
Get everybody from the Snyder Cut.
Oh, do the Squadron Supreme.
The Squadron Supreme.
Do that.
Get everybody back. Get everybody.
And then make them all go like this at the end.
Let me tell you guys something. The more I think about it, I really think they're going to make Henry Cavill Doom. I just have this weird, because the timing when they announced the Fantastic Four cast and then the Henry Cavill news broke right after that.
You know how big that could be.
If that shit happens in James Gunn's July with Superman, it's a kick in the dick. You might as well kick him in the dick. No, hit him on the way down.
He's officially got to pack up at that point.
He'd be done. He'd be fucking cooked at that point. And I think Kevin Feige is just that. What's the word I'm looking for? Petty. I think he's petty enough to do that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I think he's just petty enough to do that.
Dude, I see it now. Wait, be real petty.
Make it Hyperia.
No. You know the Grant Gustin Flash meme where he's like, he's peacing out on the tombstone. That's what we're getting. That would be it.
Literally, not kidding. Yeah, that shit would be insane. Henry. I'm telling you. Kevin Feige's petty enough to do that, bro. I'm telling you, he so is. I swear to you.
Yep.
I have a Fantastic Four comic where Doom fought Galactus on his own and invaded Latveria.
Yeah.
Doom fought him with all his Doom bots, and it was like Dr. Robotnik.
Dr. Robotnik.
Oh man.
Oh god. Oh, all right.
What a show.
Wait, who won that battle?
Didn't Doom win that fight? I think, right? He did, right?
Ah, the plot thickens.
I think he did. I'm pretty sure.
There's two fights. There's one that Doom. There's actually three. Oh, no. If I'm correct, there's four. We've seen one in Fox Universe where Doom got his ass handed to him. But that was from his Herald.
Surfer, collect my boots. I need Antonio Banderas versus
Fatal Jane. And Fatal Jane, I'm going to tell you one thing. I can need one character that can beat Superman without doing nothing.
All right. We're starting a war now?
Yeah.
We're almost 2.5 hours. Let's wrap it up.
All right, Fatal J. Tell Superman to see Silver Surfer one time.
Oh, boy. Oh,
space magic, huh? You just went right with space magic, huh?
God. He's OP with the sun and shit.
Let's see Superman
go against Silver Surfer real quick. Let me see.
All right. That's an episode, all right? Listen, we're 220 in. Ladies and gentlemen, nerds and nerdettes, thank you guys so much for joining us. We really want to know, though, in the comments below, what you guys think of this whole Fantastic Four, Superman, James Gunn, Feige, Marvel, DC situation, because it's getting crazy.
That's actually a great matchup.
Yeah, it is. We'll have to talk about that next week. But from all of us here, this is the Man Cave 101 podcast, where we give you and talk about all things nerdy.